Hey guys, it's Troy here, and I'm here for another giveaway and to talk a little bit about vintage. I've got a vintage giveaway. Go figure. Tell you a little bit about where I'm coming from. My wife and I are fairly simple in things we like to do together. We enjoy, just the two of us, being able to sit and watch a good series and binge watch them. I mean, I'm also one of those who watches stuff a little late on some things. So if we find a good series that we like to watch on television, well, you know, it may already be long gone. I'll give you an example. 24. Never saw a single episode of 24 until it was already off the air. The same with The Sopranos. So what I ended up doing with shows like that is I'd hear a lot about them, didn't jump on the bandwagon right away, because it didn't have a huge interest at first. I'd get season one. I'd find season one dirt cheap, and I'd watch it. I'd go, okay, not bad. It's worth checking out season two. And then next thing I know, we've gone through the whole series, and I may sit and watch the whole thing with my wife. Well, that kind of happened for us, like with Blindspot's another one that's still actually in its last season coming up, and we were way behind. We were like four seasons behind, something like that. So we were able to watch some on DVD. I'm the kind, I don't get Netflix. I work for a major television provider, so I get most every cable channel known to mankind, plus on-demand stuff. So I typically don't subscribe to streaming services, just because I really generally don't have to. But occasionally I'll hear about a series that people really like. There's a lot of other series too, and some of which I caught, you know, like Mad Men, because I've been attached or tangential to the advertising business for decades. I really like the premise of Mad Men, so I caught that from the beginning. There is a series out there that I've heard about from friends who have watched it and absolutely loved it. World War I is a really interesting time period, and I enjoy reading about history, seeing documentaries on the history of that time period. Well, there was a series, Downton Abbey, which is a British television show that actually was very popular here in the United States on public television. Six seasons. The show was already come and gone. Well, for Christmas for my wife, I bought her season one. She didn't really watch it. I went ahead and I watched season one. I got it here on Blu-ray. Right? I watched it myself. I said, you know what? That's actually a pretty doggone good show. It was well written. I absolutely loved the history time period. I loved the antique automobiles and the clothes and the way things with the aristocracy and the drama, and it was so well written. So I went ahead and I ordered season two. So I got season number two, and I tried watching it with my wife. She fell asleep during episode one because it was late at night. She was getting tired and she never went back to it. But I went ahead and I watched season two, binge watched that. Season two was good enough for me to order season three. Before I was done with season three, I said, it's time to order season four. There are only six seasons total. But what happened was I found that I could order seasons one through five for the same price I was gonna pay from another seller for season four. So I went ahead and I got seasons one through five on DVD. I prefer DVD over Blu-ray sometimes because I can play this on my computer if I'm sitting here at my desk, I can play it in other rooms of the house and in the car. So sometimes I just buy DVDs instead of Blu-ray, and it, my DVD player upgrades or upconverts to 1080p anyway. What's the point of all this? Well, a couple of things. Number one is the time period. It takes from 1912, the sinking of the Titanic is where the show picks up. And it takes you through the period of World War I, England's involvement in World War I, and through the 1920s. My wife and I recently went ahead and we started binge watching it together, and we've gotten through season three. I've already seen seasons 1 through 6. So I'm rewatching it together with her. And she's actually, I think she's enjoying it. I'm hoping she enjoys it more than her soap operas, because I think it's a whole lot better written. I really enjoyed that time period. So I thought I'd show you some of the fountain pens that I've come up with that are in my collection from that time period of 1912 up through the 1920s. I've got other pens here in my collection from the 30s and the 40s and the 50s that I could show you as well, but I'm trying to pick the ones that are from 1910s through the 1920s and just to show you some of those. For those of you who watch this channel, you know that I collect a lot of Waterman, so most of these are going to be Waterman, but I've got a few others. I've been trying to really get some others. I was trying to go after a few Conklin's and a few other brands here recently, and I've got some other lever fillers from that general time period, but I wasn't really sure if they were from the 20s or the 30s, so I left them in the drawer here behind me. So I'm going to show you these particular pens. Now the really cool thing, when I'm watching the show, I'm watching for what they pick up and what they write with. It's pretty neat. Okay, some of the antique pens that I've got. Let me start, I guess, with the oldest one first. And this is a dip pen. And if you watch the show of Downton Abbey, you'll see that I believe Mr. Carson had a dip pen on his desk when he was in his ledger. This one is Warren Manufacturing. It's actually was North Manchester, Indiana, is where this particular pen was made. This is from the 1800s. It sold for one penny, as I recall, for its price. And it is right here on here. I thought it was at 1 cent. Yeah, 1 cent right there. So this is a dip pen. Sorry that I had it outside the camera view there for a second, but it does say 1 cent on it. Warren Manufacturing from, and I looked it up, I did a little bit of research, and it's a non-detachable nib, so it was meant to be kind of a disposable pen once you've worn it out. But this is actually made out of like a cardboard or paper, a thick paper, with that paper wrapper around it. And I found this at a local antique shop for a couple of bucks, and this was from like the 1890s, 1880s, somewhere in there. All right, so let's look at some of the others. Waterman 12 is like from the 1917 era, somewhere in there, and it is an eyedropper, number 2 Waterman nib. And here's another one. I bought this one actually with hoping to be able to restore it a little better, but the hat has the accommodation clip on it. Here we got a Waterman 52, a Waterman 55, a Waterman 58. You notice the red ripple. I love red ripple. And this is also another 58 with a non-matching cap, and it's a clipless, beautiful black chase hard rubber on this, with either a very worn black rubber, or it was more of a smooth hard rubber here. It looks to be fairly worn, but a fantastic writing pen this one is here, with a great nib. A Waterman 452, which is a black hard rubber with a sterling silver filigree overlay on it. And this right here is a Waterman 54 that I got. And unfortunately, it actually had a number 2 nib on it instead of a number 4. So essentially, it's a Waterman 52 in a 54 body. All right, most of those pens that you just saw earlier were from the 1920s. The first couple Waterman 12s were from the 1910s. Going back through the 30s, 20s, I do believe, and we're into like a Waterman 52. In a vest pocket, in the black chased hard rubber. This one, the clip is missing on it, but it has a fantastic little springy, flexible nib. This is a no name on it. I couldn't find any markings on it whatsoever as far as branding, so it's an unknown brand, but it is also an eyedropper, just like those Waterman 12s that I found earlier, or and showed you earlier. Here we go, this is an Eclipse from the 1920s with a black chased hard rubber. This also has a broken off clip. This one I just got fixed finally. I had to do a lot of work on this nib. There's a previous video where I showed you some of that here, and it writes a incredibly juicy, wet fire hose of ink flow on it. And I want to try to dry that up just a little bit, but great writing pen now that I've got it working finally. And this is one of the latest additions, also an Eclipse brand pen from the 1920s. It's got that red mottled celluloid, and this one are lever fillers, as is the 52V. And that one, like I said, was an eyedropper. So these are just some of the pens that I've got here in my collection that are antiques. And I tried to pull the ones that I knew off the top of my head were going to be like from the 1920s and the 1910s. Okay, now that you've seen those pens, let me tell you what the giveaway is. Ground rules. Number one, you have to be subscribed to my channel. Number two, I want you to make a comment about, how about this? Your favorite TV shows, favorite series that you like to watch. You may like to binge watch them. You know, I'm the kind of guy, I prefer to have discs. I don't want to stream them. I want to have the disc in hand. I'm just peculiar that way. I'd rather have them and I can share them with friends and family. I'll let my mother borrow stuff like Game of Thrones. Yes, I have the entire Game of Thrones except for the last, you know, season, which isn't out on disc yet. But stuff like that. Even my mom wanted to borrow it. So stuff like that, okay? I like to have the discs. As I showed you, I have the discs. So you have to be subscribed to the channel. Talk about what your favorite show is that you might want to binge watch, whether you stream it, whether you got it on disc and you collect them. How about this? You're not going to like this one, some of you. You have to be in North America. Why is that? Well, a couple of things. But first and foremost is I'm giving away seasons 1, 2, and 3. I shared with you that I purchased season 1. That's on Blu-ray. So if you don't have a Blu-ray player, don't bother. Season 2 on DVD. Season 3 on DVD. These are video formatted for North America. That's where I live, North America, okay? So, you're probably not going to be able to play these, make use of them, outside of North America. So that's my second ground rule. You got to be in North America, okay? So, for those of you who are in Europe, Asia, Australia, sorry. Sucks to be you, I guess. You got to be a subscriber of my channel. Make a comment below. Make it about your favorite television show that you like to watch. You have to be in North America. Okay? Those are some of the ground rules. I'm going to give it about a week. I'll give you a chance for about a week to make comments, to view this video. And I'm going to choose a winner at random. I've been choosing a lot of winners, all of my winners at random. I actually had one here recently, which is not unusual and doesn't happen to just me, where someone doesn't respond back to me in a timely fashion, so I have to pick a secondary winner. That actually happened to my last winner. I had a primary winner, never responded back. So I said, okay, after 3 business days, and I gave him to the 4th day, still nothing back, I chose a second winner, and he got a fountain pen that I'd sent him for my last giveaway. All right, so Downton Abbey. If you've never seen the show, I do recommend it. I actually love the show. It is some fantastic. The cinematic production of this show is phenomenal. The sights, the history that's involved, the clothing, and the pens that they're using to write. Phenomenal. All the old cars. I'm just like, oh, I would love to have an antique car like that. Phenomenal. So I like the show. And since I've replaced these, I'm not going to use these anymore. I'm going to give these away. Hey, thanks for watching. I hope you like the show as much as I do. And, the Downton Abbey movie is actually coming out in September of this year. So we will be going to see that. And we'll get that disc too when it comes out.